So you see the result of state control of Hindu religious affairs. I mean, there's so many examples. Week after week, we hear about this, right? The Tirumala Tirupati priest controversy. There are actually multiple angles there. Prevention of chanting of mantras in some temples and so on. Commercialization of many temples. The various sevas based on the money that you can give, you can get a different kind of a treatment in the temple, and then people go there only for those pujas and so on. Misuse and misappropriation. This is like the biggest, effect of this, especially in South India, where the almost all the southern Indian states have these laws controlling temples. This is one big side effect, that, or maybe the main effect of this rule. We simply don't know what quantity of land has, temple land has gone off. So it's strange to, I mean, it's a real contrast, right? For thousands and thousands of years, you pick up any history material related to Bharata, you will see that kings actually donated lands, granted lands to temples. And now we have the opposite since the last 70 years, where these lands are being taken away and nobody knows where they are going. And various other issues as well, they are actually not managing it well. That's the summary. Governments were meant to take over temples so that they can rid the temple of the problem of management, and they aggravated the problem. And the last one is also especially serious: appointment of non-Hindus in temple boards as temple employees. And this is happening in few of the biggest temples, most precious and most holy temples for us. Tirupati, for example, there's a big controversy going on.